रेडियो जिंदगी 1550 AM के साथ जीजा।
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Go!
हेलो एंड वेलकम टू रेडियो जिंदगी 1550 AM। मैं हूं आपका मित्र, आपका दोस्त सनी मोजा। जी हाँ, वही सनी मोजा जिसे सुनते ही आप कहते हैं कि आज तो रेडियो जिंदगी पे मजा आ गया मजा। दोस्तों, टुडे इज थर्सडे, टाइम इज पास्ट 6 PM और आपके साथ हूं मैं, यानी कि सनी मोजा। जब ऐसी कॉम्बिनेशन होती है तो उसका मतलब सिर्फ एक होता है कि भेजा फ्राई शुरू हो चुका है। और आज का शो एकदम यूनिक है क्योंकि भेजा फ्राई की हिस्ट्री में आज हम पहली बार एक बॉलीवुड के डायरेक्टर के साथ बातचीत करने वाले हैं। ऑलराइट दोस्तों, विदाउट फर्दर एडू, लेट्स वेलकम कृष्णा डीके, द डायरेक्टर ऑफ गो गोवा गॉन टू भेजा फ्राई। डीके, वेलकम टू रेडियो जिंदगी।
हेलो, ग्लैड टू बी हियर।
सो डीके, मुझे सबसे पहले आप ये बताइए कि हाउ सेटिस्फाइड आर यू विद द क्रिटिकल रिस्पॉन्स एंड द वर्ड ऑफ माउथ पब्लिसिटी दैट गो गोवा गॉन हैज बीन गेटिंग?
Well, firstly, I'm quite happy. I mean, I'm quite overwhelmed with the response that we've been getting for the film. I mean, from the time the trailer launched, you know, there was tremendous interest and curiosity and response. And I think it's probably because of the fact that this is a completely new genre, that nobody's ever done it in Hindi cinema. And there's a lot of curious people out there, a lot of apprehensive people out there too, wondering, oh, zombie film in India, you know, I wonder how bad it is or how good it is, you know. So, but yeah, I mean, the response has been really good, and there have been some baffled responses because they couldn't quite come to terms with the zombie concept, but mostly people were, you know, excited. They love the humor. They love the, you know, just the spirit of the film, you know. It's a very, it's a film that does not take it so seriously, and I think that appeals to a lot of people as well.
And how does it feel that now you have written your name down in history books by introducing the first ever zombie film in India? Does it feel like good, proud about that?
Well, that's a tough question to answer. That's a loaded one. Yes, probably this is gonna. This, I mean, for this generation, this is probably gonna go down as the first major zombie film. But, you know, I mean, but again, like I said, that's up for interpretation. I mean, people can argue that, you know, in the 70s, there were Ramsey Brothers making movies with creatures that looked suspiciously like zombies, even though they were not called zombies, you know, and stuff like that. And for all I know, maybe there is some independent filmmaker somewhere who's made a zombie film in a region language that we don't know about, that never became famous, you know.
मैं बताना चाहता हूँ अपने दोस्तों को कि कितनी humbility दिखा रहे हैं Mr. DK. He's willing to, like, you know, he's not really answering the question because he's acknowledging all the other films which may not be the mainstream feature films. He's also acknowledging them and telling them maybe, you know, somebody has made a zombie like film before, so it feels good to have this movie. But DK, मुझे एक बात बताइए. Does it hurt even, you know, that even after making such a good movie, such a different movie, which everybody is saying is a, जिसने भी देखी है, everybody is saying it's a good movie, that is still not in the 100 crore club, the so-called 100 crore club?
Well, I mean, I don't think we started off with the expectation of making a 100 crore film. So, you know, I really don't think that's a disappointment, because even in the wildest dreams, we never did think that this would be a 100 crore film. The budget of the film is very low, actually. The budget of the film is like about 10 crores. So it's a very independent, budgeted film made at the, you know, in a controlled cost with, you know, like with an international crew, most of the crew working at a fraction of their cost because everybody believed in the concept and everybody wanted to be part of this, you know, for lack of a better word, I'll say experiment. So yeah, I mean, starting off and making a film like this, on a completely new subject, new genre, new kind of humor that people have not expected, are not used to, and then expecting to make 100 crores out of it would actually be, you know, not so smart. That's why we wanted to make the film on a very low budget. And like I said, the budget of the film is about 10 crores. And if we just want to, if the film were, you know, were treated like an experimental film and had a small run, it could still be profitable. That was the intention when we started making the film. The fact that the film caught on and there was a lot of attention, and thanks to a large extent to the presence of Saif Ali Khan, a major star in the film, that also lended it that visibility, The film went on to become much bigger, more mainstream than when what we had originally intended. But that's also the main reason I think you're bringing the 100 crore number. Without a safe in it, you wouldn't have said that number, I guess, right?
Well, no, I think I love the movie, and I think if it was based just on merit and not about people's mentality on going to watch a movie based on star, then definitely this is worth 100 crore movie, definitely. But aajkal thoda stars ka concept hai. So let's digress a bit and tell me, what's your favorite song from any 100 crore club movie? You know which movies I'm talking about, right?
I love the songs from Dabang Man. Actually, pick any song. Tere Mast Mast Do Nain.
All right. दोस्तों अभी हम सुनते हैं तेरे मस्त मस्त दो नैन और वापस आके बातचीत का सिलसिला आगे बढ़ाते हैं डीके के साथ जो कि है डायरेक्टर ऑफ गो गोवा गॉन. कहीं मत जाइएगा, गाना सुनिए और तब तक के लिए जिए जा.
आँखते रहते तुझको सांझ सवेरे, नैनों में बसियां जैसे नैन ये तेरे, नैनों में बसियां जैसे नैन ये तेरे.
तेरे मस्त मस्त दो नैन मेरे दिल का ले गए चैन, मेरे दिल का ले गए चैन. तेरे मस्त मस्त दो नैन. पहले पहल तुझे देखा तो दिल मेरा धड़का हाय धड़का धड़का हाय. पहले पहल तुझे देखा तो दिल मेरा धड़का हाय धड़का धड़का. जल जल उठा हूँ मैं शोला जो प्यार का भड़का है भड़का भड़का है. नींदों में घुल गए हैं सपने जो तेरे, बदले से लग रहे हैं अंदाज मेरे, बदले से लग रहे हैं अंदाज मेरे.
तेरे मस्त मस्त दो नैन मेरे दिल का ले गए चैन, मेरे दिल का ले गए चैन. तेरे मस्त मस्त दो नैन. दिल ये बेताब सा तड़पा जाए तड़पा तड़पा जाए. माही बेताब सा दिल ये बेताब सा तड़पा जाए तड़पा तड़पा जाए. नैनों की झील में उतरा था यूं ही दिल, डूबा जाए डूबा डूबा जाए. होशो हवास अब तो होने लगे हैं, हम भी दीवाने तेरे होने लगे हैं, हम भी दीवाने तेरे होने लगे.
मेरे मस्त मस्त दो नैन मेरे दिल का ले गए चैन, मेरे दिल
आज सवेरे नैनों में बसिया जैसे नैन ये तेरे नैनों में बसिया जैसे नैन ये तेरे
तेरे मस्त मस्त दो नैन मेरे दिल का ले गए चैन मेरे दिल का ले गए चैन तेरे मस्त मस्त दो नैन
वेलकम बैक दोस्तों, आप सुन रहे हैं भेजा प्राइस सनी मोजा और डीके के साथ. सो डीके, वी नो दैट यू आर अ बिग शॉट डायरेक्टर इन बॉलीवुड, बट टेल मी, आई वांट टू नो एंड आवर ऑडियंस वांट्स टू नो, हु इज कृष्णा डीके?
Oh, wow. Nobody's ever asked me that question quite like that. Well, I grew up in the south in Andhra Pradesh. When I was there for the initial about 20 or odd years of my life, did my engineering, and in engineering is where actually I met Raj. He's my directing partner.
Mm-hmm.
And so we were friends from engineering college, and then afterwards we both kind of moved to the US separately. He was living in Detroit, I was mostly living in the Midwest between Iowa, Minneapolis, sometimes Texas, doing software consulting jobs. That was our previous lives.
Exciting.
And then somewhere there, at one point, it thought that life was getting a little monotonous, a little boring, and so we thought we should start dabbling in something creative. So we started taking baby steps. Initially, we started wrote a couple of scripts with the intention of selling it to a Hollywood studio and making a lot of money or something like that. But obviously, it's a very naive idea. It doesn't work like that. So after a while, we started getting into filmmaking, started learning one by one the little tricks of filmmaking, like took editing classes, took some, lighting classes and stuff like that. And then started making a bunch of short films, just learning on the go. And then eventually ended up making our first feature film called Flavors, which we were in New York, New Jersey, and we shot that.
Okay.
And that's where the journey started.
Okay. And so what prompted you to move from US back to India? That's a big move, because everything else, people do that. People come here, do their engineering, do these things on the side. But going back and leaving your lucrative jobs in the US, it's a big move. What prompted that?
Well, right now, looking back, yes, it was a big move. For some reason, then at that time, it didn't seem like that, because I think the way we kind of did it was we always had one foot on the side and, kept one foot in the filmmaking a little bit for a little while. Right after Flavors, we came to India. We went to India to release Flavors.
Mm-hmm.
And when we were there, we kind of started looking around at the films that were being made and kind of felt that maybe, we could do some justice there. We could make a film like a Hindi language film, like a Hindi film, but not necessarily the kind of films that are being made. I mean, somewhere I think we felt that we had something new to offer. That's how the script of 99 came about.
Okay.
And once we had the script of 99 ready, then the process was to get it, get it cast and get the, production going and everything. But very quickly we realized that it's very expensive living in Bombay, and obviously, we don't really have any sort of income. So what we did was we came back to the U.S. actually after Flavors, after we wrote the script of 99, we came back to the U.S. Went back into consulting, software consulting, worked for a couple of years with the sole intention of not building a career, but just making a lot of money so that we could save enough and then go back to India and, live there, survive there for a few years and then see how it goes. So that's how it happened. Once we went back to India, sat there, started casting the film, got the film going, and, you know, then the 99, that's how it got made. Even then, I guess there might have been a shred of, a possibility that, you know, you might have to go back to a software job, but not that we wanted to, but might have been, you know. But then very quickly things fell in place. We made sure in the city afterwards, we made Gogoban afterwards, and now, we're pretty much fully, you know, into filmmaking, based there, doing it. But like I said, when it started off, it kind of started off as, you know, let's see if we can do it, but we better hang on to our software jobs, kind of a move.
Right. So tell me something. You said you felt that you had something new to offer to Bollywood. Mm-hmm. How did you convince Bollywood that you have something new to offer?
Well, Bollywood, you mean in terms of the actors and stuff?
Actors and other people, because you know how it's a huge, it's not just, you know, you can have a great idea, you can have a great script, you can even have the money, but to get the movie to completion and to actually release it, having great actors, you had like Baman Irani, Raj Babbar in the first film, you have Kunal Kemu in there. So these are big actors. Like, how did you convince them that you can actually do it?
Well, surprisingly, it wasn't that hard. No matter what the films are that you're seeing, no matter what you're seeing actors doing, I think practically every actor I have met so far in Mumbai wants to do something different. They're always up for it. They're always looking for something different. It's now more so, especially now than, say, a few years ago. Everybody's kind of feeling that, you know, the same old, it might be working for a while, but everybody kind of wants to do something different. So whoever we went and pitched the script to, they were always like, oh, wow, this is super. And of course, some of them had their other, constraints and not do it, but those who wanted to do it, they did it wholeheartedly. And the biggest case in point is Gogoban. How does a film like Gogoban get made? By a major superstar. Because he wants to do something different, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And so that's where, I think that's the kind of spirit that I'm seeing a lot of everywhere in Mumbai right now. All the big actors, they're looking for that one different film. Otherwise, they're happy. I mean, they're kind of doing what they're doing because that's their bread and butter, but I think they always want to do this one different film that they really like doing as well.
So on that note, DK, tell me, what song would you like to hear from 99?
Delhi Destiny.
All right. So, dosto, sunte hain Delhi Destiny. Mast gana hai from the film 99. This was one of the hits of 2009. Aur uske baad wapis aake apna silsila aage badhate hain DK ke saath baatcheet ka. Kahin mat jaiyega aur jiye ja. नमस्कार दोस्तों, आप सुन रहे हैं भेजा फ्राइज सनी मोजा के साथ ओनली ऑन रेडियो जिंदगी 1550 AM। और जैसा कि आप जानते हैं, आज हमारी बातचीत का सिलसिला चल रहा है कृष्णा डीके के साथ, जो कि हैं डायरेक्टर फ्रॉम द मूवी गो गोवा गॉन। उससे पहले वो बना चुके हैं श्योर इन द सिटी एंड 99 फ्लेवर्स। US वालों ने तो देखी होगी, गारंटी देता हूँ। आइए उनसे बातचीत का सिलसिला आगे बढ़ाते हैं। तो डीके, टेल मी समथिंग, एट एनी पॉइंट डू यू मिस योर जॉब हियर?
Honestly, no. Not the job itself. But yeah, but there's a lot to be said about just having a simple 9-to-5 lifestyle, you know, in the US, where everything is a little more organized, as opposed to facing a daily battle of any kind, you know, creative or administrative or financial, just trying to meet schedules that you face with when you're doing when you're in filmmaking. But having said that, I don't think I can survive a software job, you know, for more than a month anymore. But yeah, I mean, it's once in a while I like to come back to the States, even though I'm making films in India. Once in a while, like, you know, for a month I like to come back to the States, and in fact I go to Iowa, which is probably the exact opposite of Mumbai. So I can just sit there and chill. There's no crowd, no traffic, no noise. And like, I don't know, it's like living in an ashram. That usually gets my energies back, you know, get my creative juices flowing, and, you know, maybe end up writing a script when I'm sitting there.
How long does it take usually to write a script? I know there's no like answer. It depends on how creative you're feeling. But in general, the 4 scripts you have written so far, or the 4 films you have made so far, how long did it take on an average?
Like you said, it is a little complicated question to answer, because usually the way it works is at some point you end up with an idea, right? I mean, either me or Raj or, you know, we end up with an idea of a concept or something, then we start kind of discussing it, you know, off and on. Mm-hmm. It's never like a you never wake up one day and have a fully fleshed out story anyway, right? You're just going to have a vague idea of a concept or something, and then you start building a plot, story. So this goes on for, usually, sometimes it goes on for months, because invariably what happens is you're already doing something. You're already making a film, or you're already writing another script or something, but this idea already cropped up. So you start, you know, discussing. At some point there is a certain form to it, so you know that at some point you can make a movie on this. And then once you think it's the time to do that, when you think, okay, this is the subject, now let's pick this as the next film, then you sit and you start discussing, and you come up with a structure, story, plot, characters, all the elements that get into making a script before you even start writing the script. So that can take some time. Mm-hmm. That can take also a month or two. And then what we typically do is we, once we have the full story in place, like once we know that this is the story and we have an approximate structure, skeleton structure for it, then we sit and write the script. And that's how everybody else writes it too. I don't think anybody would start writing a script without knowing where the story is going. Script is always the last thing that comes once you have a full story in place. The actual process of writing a screenplay, I don't know, it probably takes about a month.
Okay.
You know, it shouldn't take longer than that, because by now you know your characters, you know your story, you know your entire plot, almost the scenes, everything.
But tell me one more follow-up question is that, you know, you understand Hindi, but you don't speak Hindi very well, and you are writing movies in Hindi. How does that work?
good question, but like I said, I understand Hindi, right? I mean, we understand Hindi, and we can even speak Hindi. It's just not a pretty sight, so I don't want to subject your listeners to that.
DK, एक लाइन हो जाए आपकी किसी मूवी की हिंदी में.
ऐसी कोई बात नहीं, मतलब बात भी कर सकता हूँ, लेकिन हाँ, जो भी सुनते हैं थोड़ा शायद, you know, हंसेंगे सुनके.
नहीं, आई थिंक इट्स वेरी क्यूट. इनफैक्ट आपकी हिंदी सुन के मुझे एक गाना याद आ रहा है, जो मैं आपको और अपने लिसनर्स को जरूर सुनाऊंगा. तो दोस्तों, चाहे नॉर्थ हो या फिर साउथ, हम इंडियंस को एक चीज जरूर जोड़ के रखती है, और वो है हमारी फिल्में. जिए जा और प्यार किए जा.
मेरे जीवन साथी, प्यार किए जा.
बाबा.
मेरे जीवन साथी, प्यार किए जा शिवम सुंदरम सत्यम शिवम सुंदरम सत्यम शिवम सुंदरम
झूठा कहीं का
झूठा कहीं का हरे राम हरे कृष्णा
420 आवारा
दिल ही तो है काशी खूबहारों का तेरे मेरे सपने तेरे घर के सामने आमने सामने शादी के बाद
ओ बापरी
हमारे तुम्हारे मुन्ना गुड्डी टिंकू मिली शिंशना की बबला पू खेल खेल में शोर
शोर
भूल गए
जाने मेरा नाम
अच्छा?
चोरी मेरा काम जाने मेरा नाम और चोरी मेरा काम राम और शाम
बंडल बाज
लड़के मिलन गीत गाता चल
बेशरम
प्यार का मौसम
बेशरम
सत्यम शिवम सुंदरम सत्यम शिवम सुंदरम सत्यम शिवम सुंदरम मेरे जीवन साथी प्यार किए जा
चाचा
जवानी दीवानी खूबसूरत सिद्धि पड़ोसन सत्यम शिवम सुंदरम सफर हम सफर दिल तेरा दीवाना दीवाना मस्ताना चलिया अनजाना
पगला कहीं का
चलिया अनजाना आशिक बेगाना लोफर अनाड़ी बढ़ती का नाम दौड़ी चलती का नाम गाड़ी बढ़ती का नाम दौड़ी चलती का नाम गाड़ी जब प्यार किसी से होता है सनम जब यार जाने मन
सच
बंधन कंगन चंदन झूला चंदन कंगन बंधन झूला कंगन झूला चंदन झूला 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 दिल दिया दर्द लिया जनक जनक पायल बाजे चम चमा चम गीत गाया पत्थरों में सरगम सत्यम शिवम सुंदरम सत्यम शिवम सुंदरम सत्यम शिवम सुंदरम मेरे जीवन साथी प्यार किए जा
चल चल
जवानी दीवानी खूबसूरत जीती पड़ोसन सत्यम शिवम सुंदरम सिंग मी कम ऑन ला 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 गुड डांसिंग ला ला ला
वेलकम बैक दोस्तों तो डी के आपने जो ये गाना रखा है गो गोवा गॉन में खून चूस ले क्या ये आपके अपने एक्सपीरियंस से है जब आप सॉफ्टवेयर इंजीनियर थे
एब्सोल्युटली नॉट जस्ट सॉफ्टवेयर इंजीनियर आई थिंक एनी जॉब आई मीन प्रोबेबली ऑल द ऑफिस जॉब्स एट लीस्ट आर अ स्लेव टू द 9 to 5 मंडे टू फ्राइडे इन अमेरिका मंडे टू सैटरडे सैडली in India, in some places at least. They are a slave to the jobs, and I think Monday is probably, I think the Monday sentiment is shared in universally by everyone everywhere. I mean, anybody who has a 9-to-5 job that they have to go to. And so yeah, the song came up, the concept of the song, the Monday song, came up from that, saying you're kind of living this, you know, for lack, you know, in a vague sense, a zombie-like existence. You wake up to the alarm, you go, you put on your coffee on the pot, you have your coffee, you dress up, you go to work, you start doing the, you know. It kind of, that's a parallel we were trying to draw. And then, of course, since it's a zombie film, you know, the words "cool juice lay" made more sense than it would normally make in any other film, because people immediately connected to the zombie. I think the Monday sentiment is something that everybody pretty much shares, you know.
Absolutely, and especially here in the Bay Area, where people are tired of Saturday and Sunday party, kar kar ke thak jate hain. Unke liye jaise hi Monday unka khoon chusta hai, unko to bahut acha lagta hai gana. Anyways, dosto, aaiye sunte hain "Khoon Chus Le" from Go Goa Gone. Aur wapis aake hamari bahut baatcheet bachi hai. We'll also play a rapid fire round with DK. So, "Khoon Chus Le" from Go Goa Gone and Jieja.
meri jaan ka ke khoon chusne tu aaya khoon chusne tadi khooni mande kyu aaya khoon chusne tu jaa 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 kabutar jaa nahi jaana
बैक दोस्तों, आप सुन रहे हैं भेजा फ्राई सनी मोजा के साथ, और आज हमारे स्पेशल गेस्ट हैं डीके, हु इज द डायरेक्टर ऑफ गो गोवा गॉन. तो डीके, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू प्ले अ रैपिड फायर राउंड विद यू. व्हाट दैट मींस इज दैट मैं कुछ बोलूंगा आपको, किसी का नाम और समथिंग, यू हैव टू टेल मी द फर्स्ट थॉट दैट कम्स टू योर माइंड. सैफ अली खान.
बोरिस.
फ्लेवर्स.
एनआरआई.
राजनिधि मोरो.
माय फ्रेंड.
सॉफ्टवेयर इंजीनियरिंग.
Programming, boring.
99
cricket.
Kunal Kemo.
Talented.
Pick one. Love, Hardik or Bunny?
Bunny.
Hollywood or Bollywood?
Hollywood.
Himesh Rishamia or Rahat Fateh Ali Khan?
Neither.
Alright. Karan Johar or Anurag Basu?
Anurag Basu.
Alright. good answers there. And by the way, DK, I loved the song. Mujhe baad mein Kunal se malum pada ki Baba Ji ki booty was almost like an afterthought. It came later on in the movie. It was such an awesome song.
Thank you. Yeah. I mean, we all enjoyed it. I mean, obviously all of us sang the song. I mean, there's me, there's Raj, there's Kunal, there's Anand. Unfortunately, Veer was not available. Otherwise, he would have also been able to sing the song. The composers, everybody that worked in the film were actually singing the song, you know.
Oh, great. That's news to me. I didn't know that.
Yeah, it's all our voices.
In fact, just to give you a compliment, DK, kal main kaam pe baitha hua tha and I was playing this song in the background. I was playing all the Indian songs and this song started, Baba Ji Ki Booty. And I had my co-worker who has no clue about Indian songs. And guess what she said? She said, this is my favorite track.
Oh, really?
Yes. It happened yesterday only and I'm not making it up. Her name is Jessica. I'll also tell her to listen to the show. And
maybe it was my voice that was captivating, you know, I don't know.
I'll pass on your number to her.
sure.
So, dosto, aaiye sunte hain Baba Ji Ki Booty, my favorite song from Go Goa Gone, Jeja.
Le maar.
Baba Ji Ki Booty.
Baba Ji Ki Booty.
Baba Ji Ki Booty. Baba Ji Ki Booty.
Jo bhari chilam bane hum hero life lage film samasya zero daru bandon ki gandi harkat booty upar wale ki barkat Baba Ji Ki Booty. Baba Ji Ki Booty.
Beautiful Baba Ji. Oh, agar kisi ladki ka chakkar ya ho boss
tera Ravan ka puttar bhooti
har duvidha ka solution bhoo de frustration mein potion Baba Ji Ki Booty. Baba Ji Ki Booty.
वो देख वो क्या है?
पंछी है क्या?
ना रे पगले, प्लेन.
अरे देख अंडरवेयर बाहर है, सुपरमैन.
ना, दैट इज बाबा जी. बाबा जी की जय हो बाबा जी की. ऊंचाइयों को गहराइयों में लीन कर दीजिए, आत्मा के रैम से ट्रॉमा का स्पैम क्लीन कर दीजिए. यहाँ अमीर गरीब में कोई भेद नहीं है, बाबा के सीधे प्रसारण में रुकावट तो है मगर रुकावट के लिए साला कोई खेद नहीं है. समस्या के मिडिल फिंगर पे समाधान की अंगूठी बाबा जी की बूटी. बाबा जी की बूटी. बाबा जी आई लव यू.
जी जा
वेलकम बैक दोस्तों, जैसा कि आप जानते हैं चल रहा है सिलसिला भेजा फ्राई का सनी मोजा के साथ, और आज के स्पेशल गेस्ट हैं डीके द डायरेक्टर ऑफ गो गोवा गॉन, जो अभी भी थिएटर्स में लगी हुई है। अगर आपने वो मूवी नहीं देखी है तो टेक माय वर्ड, इट्स अ ट्रूली डिफरेंट मूवी एंड ट्रूली फनी मूवी। आज ही जाके देखिए और मुझे कॉल करके अपना फीडबैक दीजिए कि आपको मूवी कैसी लगी। तो डीके, टेल मी समथिंग, आई वॉच ऑल योर मूवी सिंस फ्लेवर्स। मैंने देखा है कि यू डोंट हैव टू मेनी सॉन्ग्स, इनफैक्ट आई डोंट इवन रिकॉल वन सॉन्ग which is lip synced, like actors are not singing the song, or maybe you had one or two, but mostly all the songs are in the background. Is that a conscious effort?
Of course it's a conscious effort. I mean, I think it's kind of the way we are heading now. I mean, as filmmakers, we are making films in Hindi, but like, I mean, the effort is to make a good movie, tell a good story, but not necessarily stick to the conventions of the industry, not necessarily if you have to, and as long as the audience will permit us that, you know, it's all the more better for us. But so far we've gotten away by making films where, of course, we love songs, we love music, but as part of the narrative. You know, I somehow feel it a little disruptive when a movie is going on and people break out of character and go, you know, there's a song and dance break, and then they come back into the movie. It kind of, you know, I guess that's true for anybody who has a little Hollywood bent of mind, or if you've been watching Hollywood films. And you know how, I mean, you live in America, right? You know how most Americans would make fun of the song and dance situations in Indian cinema. So it's not, you know, so it's not exactly a natural thing that you can have a song and dance in a movie. And the way we write our movies, the way we kind of think of the story and write the screenplay, and we do have songs, we like to have songs, but not necessarily a song and dance break. You know, something that's more integrated in the movie. And that's true for all the films we've made so far.
Right. Yeah, I noticed that. It's a very good, almost like a culmination of Hollywood and Bollywood. So that's really good. So DK, tell me something. From Flavors to Go Go Gone, what has changed in Raj and DK since then?
Well, I mean, hopefully, I like to think that we're getting better. And we've been learning, right? I mean, as we make each film, we learn more and more. I mean, Flavors was a very, very small indie film, practically a homemade film. You know, we produced it and we practically did everything on the film. We even edited the film, you know, at one point. And so that was Flavors. And then once we went to 99, we were dabbling in a more mainstream format and working with the crew that were, you know, actually experienced crew and experienced actors, some of them iconic actors as well. So, you know, you learn a lot from that, from the process. But I think at the core of it, I think we have a certain sense of humor, a certain style of storytelling, which we like to retain. And I think so far we have kind of successfully retained that in all our films, regardless of the genre, regardless of the scope and scale. And so I think with each film, I think, I don't know, it's actually for you to say if we've been maturing with each film, but I feel that we've been learning with each film. We're getting better.
I think you started off on a high too, because Flavors was not like, you know, didn't look like, I know technically it might not be where your other films are today, but as far as story is concerned, the way of storytelling is concerned, it was a very superior film. So DK, you said Go Goa Gone was a 10 crore movie. What was the budget of Flavors at the time?
Do you really want to know?
Absolutely, I want to know. I heard it was 200,000, which is, I think, 1 crore now.
Yeah, it was about that. It was actually $200,000 approximately. And even then, most of that money actually went into the, you know, in those days, making the film print, like conversion from digital to film, actually took a big chunk of it. So the actual cost of making the film was even much lesser than that, you know, to the point of having a finished film before you make a film print. That cost was even lesser. But yeah, 200,000 is a good budget for that film.
So DK, you are a director duo, Raj and DK. Aapki chemistry kaisi hai? I mean, how do you resolve your creative differences?
Well, usually we resolve before we get onto the set, right? I mean, obviously we write the script together, and so we've kind of lived the film, you know, as an entity for much longer than anybody else who comes on the film. So most of our differences are kind of resolved right there when it comes to, you know, script level differences. And you know, we've been friends for a long time and we got into films together and kind of had the similar influences. So I think that also helps a lot. So most of the time we see eye to eye. We like, you know, what either one of us is doing most of the time. In case there is a certain case where, you know, about 20% of the time, then you differ in your opinion, then we, you know, kind of talk it out, debate it out, and pick whatever is a better option. We rarely, I mean, in fact, I don't think we ever show our difference in front of, like, the crew or on the set. It's usually something we take care of before we come on set. When we come on set, we go with the decision saying, this is how we're going to do it. So as far as the actors and technicians and everybody is concerned, it's just, it could be one director.
Okay. And where does Sita Menon fit into Raj DK team?
Yeah, and she's like a creative partner kind of behind the scenes. She usually has always been involved to us, I mean, in all our scripts from the very beginning stages, you know, with the development of the scripts and everything. And later on also she gets very creatively involved in the film in terms of styling and look and all kinds of things. So she's always been a part of the journey from the very beginning till the very end.
Yeah, absolutely. And I'm sure what I'm going to say, it's not the first time you're hearing this, that Shor in the City mein, Tushar Kapoor is uski matlab best acting hai probably in any movie. I mean, how did you make that happen?
I mean, a lot of the credit goes to Tushar Kapoor, right? I mean, obviously, he did the job. And as a director, I think it's our job to just guide him in the right direction, get what's already in him, get it out. I mean, we cannot take a bad actor and make him a good actor, obviously. What we can do is take somebody who already has it in him and, you know, put him on the right path so the best in him comes out. And I think that's what happened with Tushar. I mean, I think he's just been doing certain kind of roles and being characterized a certain way. And then when he got a good role, that kind of suited him as well. And I think a lot of, to some extent, we also tailored the role to suit his personality. I mean, it would have, you know, that also helped him to kind of become the character he became in the film.
Okay, and you didn't have any obligation to take Tushar in the movie because of Balaji connection?
Obligation? No. They didn't actually force us to take him, but the way it started was when they were going to produce the film and, you know, as a suggestion, they said, why don't you meet Tushar? You know, maybe you could use him for a role. And we felt that, you know, the role of Tilak, Tushar, would fit very well. Cause, I mean, if he was willing to have a makeover in his look, like really, you know, go a little more rasta, like as in cut his hair short, grow a beard, look a little rugged, you know, not look as clean cut as he does in his other films. And so actually, we were actually thinking that he might not want to do the role because, you know, it's one role out of many and he may or may not be up for it. But, you know, the moment he heard the character, he was like, oh, I'd love to do this. And we were like, okay, we'd love to have you do this. And it was like a mutually agreeable thing.
All right. I mean, it all in all, the end result was beautiful. Thanks to you. Thanks to Tushar. He did do very well. So, dosto, jo bhi hota hai life mein, ye sab karmo ka phal hota hai. Ye to hum sab jante hain. To isliye aaiye sunte hain Karma is a Bitch from the movie Shor in the City. Aur aake hum wrap up karenge apni baatcheet DK ke saath. Jiye ja.
Nahi, 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 re bacha hai koi iski chhod.
ऑलराइट दोस्तों, आप सुन रहे हैं भेजा फ्राइज सनी मोजा के साथ। डीके, एज यू नो, बे एरिया में स्पेशली बहुत ही बडिंग एक्टर्स, बडिंग डायरेक्टर्स, फिल्म मेकर्स बहुत सारे हैं। व्हाट्स योर मैसेज फॉर देम कि उनको भी अपना काम धंधा छोड़ के बॉम्बे चला जाना चाहिए?
एक्चुअली नो, दैट्स वन थिंग आई वुड टेल पीपल नॉट टू डू इज जस्ट टेक द प्लंज एंड यू नो जस्ट ड्रॉप एवरीथिंग एंड गो। इट्स अ ह्यूज रिस्क। I would ask people to be a little more realistic in their choices, as in, you know, you don't suddenly assume you're a great actor and just decide to give up everything and go. I mean, it would help if you took the right courses, you know, met with the right people and, you know, see where it goes. Take one step at a time. Also get an opinion, get an expert opinion. I mean, when we made our first short film, we made it not with the intention of dropping everything and becoming filmmakers. And when we made our first short film, if everybody who saw the film had said it's a crappy film, I think we would have stopped making films right there. As it turns out, the people liked the film. In fact, it went to film festivals and won awards. That kind of validated something that we believed, that we had some talent to go out and make a film. So you do require a little bit of outside validation besides yourself and your friends and family. And having said that, it's a tough world out there. It's a very, very tough world, especially for actors, because actors, you know, more than, say, directors and writers, actors have less control over what they do. You know, they are waiting to be picked by the right project, into the right project. Whereas a writer or a director can go and make his own project, you know, given the right conditions that way. So it's a very risky world. So I would suggest you be very realistic about your expectations and be cautious. And you'd rather be successful in what you're doing rather than be a, say, failed actor in that sense, or as somebody who's just struggling to make it but not being able to make it. So take one step at a time.
Alright, so दोस्तों सुना आपने, ये थी डीके की एडवाइस हम सब बडिंग एक्टर्स और बडिंग फिल्ममेकर्स के लिए। डीके, एनी पार्टिंग वर्ड्स फॉर द ऑडियंस ऑफ यूएस? दिस स्टेशन प्लेज इन अबाउट 7 स्टेट्स नाउ, सो व्हाट्स योर मैसेज और एनीथिंग दैट यू वांट टू से टू देम, बिकॉज़ वी ऑल लव योर फिल्म्स।
वेल, थैंक यू। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, थैंक्स फॉर हैविंग मी ऑन द शो। आई मीन, ऑब्वियसली आई वाज लिविंग इन द स्टेट्स, लिसनिंग टू रेडियो शोज लाइक दिस फ्यू इयर्स बैक, एंड नाउ आई मीन आई मूव्ड टू मुंबई, बट good to be back here making my next film here in LA, and I'm looking forward to that. It's like life making a full circle. I mean, I made my first film in New York, and now on my fifth film, I think, right? Yeah, fifth film. I'm in LA, and that's a good feeling.
All right, and DK, on that one, what's the name of the film that you're making now?
Well, we're tentatively calling it Happy Ending.
Happy Ending.
Yeah, it's a rom-com. It's a romantic comedy. It's also kind of a satire on romantic comedies. It's a self-referential romantic comedy. And, you know, I think it's, I mean, at least we all think it's very funny. It's more more calm than rom, you know, in a rom-com. Mm-hmm. And I look forward to making this film here. I mean, I'm already loving LA. I'm in LA and looking at all the locations, going around. I love the weather. I love the people. I love everything here.
So all right.
Good to be back.
I mean, happy ending पे मैं तो कोई comment नहीं करने वाला हूँ, लेकिन with that note, we want to thank you from the whole team of Radio Zindagi and Bheja Fry. Thank you so much for taking time and being on air with us. Thank you so much, DK.
And thanks for having me here, man.
Alright दोस्तों, this is time for Sunny Moza to sign off, लेकिन अगले Thursday मैं फिर वापस आऊंगा आपका भेजा फ्राई करने के लिए। अगर आपको आज का शो अच्छा लगा तो मेरे Facebook पे जाके जरूर मुझे बताइए। My Facebook is facebook.com/sunnymoza. facebook.com/sunnymoza. So until next time, adios, shabba khair, khuda hafiz, and take care. Jeeja.